The U.S. Air Force insists its ongoing aerial combat exercises with the Philippines are not meant to target any current threats. The details from Bianca Dava.
The Philippine Air Force on Thursday trained side by side with the United States Pacific Air Forces as part of the first iteration of their bilateral Cope Thunder exercise this year. Members of the two air forces conducted basic fighter maneuvers at the Basa Air Base in Pampanga. The drills allowed them to show their capability and readiness to respond to possible threats in the region. In the drills conducted today, Americans flew four of their F-16 fighter aircraft, while Filipinos also used four of our F-A-50 lead-in fighter aircraft. The air operation drills were conducted over waters in the western side of Zambales.
For today, for this week, we have air-to-air exercises up until next week. It will be composed of basic fighter maneuvers to air combat maneuvers up until tactical intercept. And then after that, after which, we'll be having some limited air-to-surface.
We practice interoperability here, so we're trying to prepare our pilots in terms of the communication standards, in terms of tactics, techniques, and procedures.
Philippine Air Force spokesperson Colonel Maria Consuelo Castillo said the Cope Thunder training is part of the country's preparations for participating in international exercises, specifically the Australian-led Pitch Black Warfare exercise scheduled in July. For the first time, the PAF will send its F-A-50 lead-in trainer fighter aircraft to the drills.
We're going to have our biggest participation so far in the Pitch Black exercise, which is expected to happen in Australia by July, July to August. And kung previous years ng Pitch Black exercise sa Australia, normally nagpapadala lang tayo ng observers. This time, we are planning to send fighter aircraft. So, magkakaroon tayo ng large force deployment.
The U.S. Air Force stressed, Cope Thunder is not directed towards the Philippines' challenges to its territory and sovereign rights. Instead, the exercise aims to strengthen the two air forces' bilateral partnership to maintain a free and open Indo-Pacific.
And we've been doing exercises like this for many years now, and we'll continue to do so. And not because of any current things going on in the world right now, but just because both the U.S. and the Philippine Air Force believe that as we work together to make a free and open Indo-Pacific, we prepare ourselves to operate in a joint environment one day for not any current present threat, but potentially future threats that we might even not know about yet.
Aside from field exercises, the Filipino and American airmen also conducted subject matter expert exchanges on maritime strike and anti-ship tactics. The first iteration of Cope Thunder will run until April 19. A second iteration is scheduled in June. Meanwhile, the Philippine Air Force is expecting the arrival of more air assets in the next 2 years as part of Horizon 2 of the AFP modernization program.
This year, we are expecting more aircraft coming in as part of our acquisition and modernization program under the Horizon 2. So, may mga contracts na to, and for the next 1 to 2 years, we are expecting them to come in. We're expecting more Black Hawk helicopters. We are expecting C-130s.
Multi-role fighters, which have been on the PAF's wish list for quite some time now, are expected to be acquired under Horizon 3. Bianca Dava, ABS-CBN News, Florida Blanca, Pampanga.